वर्किंग एज ए प्रोफेसर इन सी एस सी डिपार्टमेंट एट सेंट एंड्रयू इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट गुरुग्राम। इन ऑनलाइन सीरीज टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सिस्टम कॉल्स एंड द जनरेशन ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। टुडे बेसिकली सिस्टम कॉल्स प्रोवाइड द इंटरफेस बिटवीन ए प्रोसेस एंड द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स। एज आई टोल्ड यू इन बिफोर लेक्चर, ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम बेसिकली एक्ट एज इंटरफेस बिटवीन द यूजर एंड हार्डवेयर, बट इन बिटवीन द प्रोसेस एंड द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स द सिस्टम कॉल एग्जिस्ट विच एक्ट एज इंटरफेस बिटवीन द प्रोसेस एंड द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। द सिस्टम कॉल्स एक्ट एज इंटरमीडिएटरी बिटवीन द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड द यूजर्स। दीज आर यूजली अवेलेबल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ असेंबली लैंग्वेज इंस्ट्रक्शंस। दिस सिस्टम कॉल्स इज मेड अप इन असेंबली लैंग्वेज। Some systems allow systems calls to be made directly from high level language program like C, BPCL and Perl, etc. But some systems allow to make the system calls in high level language like C, BPCL and Perl also. It depends on the computer to computer system. System calls are grouped into 5 categories. Basically, what happens operating system when we do any task, so the system call is generated related to the task. Suppose I want to create a process, so the create process system calls will generate to create the process. Here the system number one, the category of system calls is number one, process control. Process control means what is the process? Process in program in execution. And what is a program? Program is a set of instructions. So when we create, delete, abort, waiting and some task related to the process, a system calls is generated to perform the task. So another word, this is the system calls of the process. In another word, a running program need to be able to have its execution either normally or abnormally. Abnormally means, abort means it's suspended the process forcefully. Next system calls related to the process control, load and execute. A process or job executing one program may want to load and execute another program. Suppose a process executing and he want to load the another program, so the load command is used and execute system call is used for the execution of the process or the programs. Next, system calls is create process, terminate process. Create means the generation of the process, creation of the process. This system calls specify for the purpose of creating new process or jobs. When we want to terminate a job or process, that we create the terminate system calls for the termination of the process. Next is get process attributes and set process attributes. If you create a new job or process, we should able to control its execution. This control require the ability to determine and reset the attributes for the job or the process. Here the get and set process system calls is used. Next is wait time. Wait time is after creating a new job or process, we may need to wait for them to finish their executions. Means in multi-programming concept, the more than program reside in the primary memory, so the execution of the process execute according to the scheduling criteria. So some process have to be wait in the RAM. So the wait time system calls is used for that purpose. Next is wait event and signal event. We may wait for a specific event to occur. The job process then signal when the event has occurred. So this is used for the execution of process. Wait and signal event is generated for the related process. Next system calls category is file manipulation. File manipulation means if we do some task related to the file, a system calls is also generated. The category of file manipulation system calls are given here. Number one, create files and delete file. Create file, suppose we are creating a file, the system calls is generated and he told to the operating system the user want to create a file. So the create file is system call is generated for the creation of the process. Same in the case of deletion, suppose you want to delete a file, the delete calls is generated for to complete the task. Open file and close file. Open means suppose we have a saved file in our RAM, sorry, in hard disk, and we want to open the file, so the open system file system calls is created, and same for the close file also. Read, write and reposition of files. Reading, suppose we want to read the data, so the read system call generate, and same for the writing. Suppose I want to write something in the file, so the write system calls generated, and suppose I want to reposition our file from one place to another, so the reposition file system calls is generated for the this purpose. Get file attributes, next category of system calls get file attributes and set file attributes. For either files or directory, we need to able to determine the values of various attributes and reset them if necessary. Two system calls, get file attributes and set file attributes, are required for this purpose. The next category of system calls is device management. Device management means the system resources are available or not. Request device and release device. If there are multiple users of systems, comma, first request the device. After we finish with the device, we must release it. Suppose I want to print the paper in the printer and I attach through the network, so I will request for the printer if I complete my printing work, so then I have to release device command to release the printer also. So request and release device system calls is used for the purpose. Read, write and repositions. Read means same, suppose I want to read data, write data, reposition, so the system, this system calls is used for the purpose. Next category of system calls is information maintenance. The following category of system calls come under this information maintenance system calls. Number one, get time or date, set time or date. Most system have a system calls to return the current dates and time, to set the current date and time. As you see in the computer, it show the current date and time in the monitor at below position, at below right position. So this task is done automatically by the operating system with the help of get time or date and set time or date system calls. Get system data and set system data. This is used to return the information about the systems, like number of current users, version number of operating system and amount of free memory, etc. This is used for these three purpose. For the current number of current, how much user are using the systems, and what is the version of operating systems, or the how much memory is available. Get process attributes and set process attributes. This is the next category of system calls of information maintenance. Here the operating system keeps information about all its process, and there are system calls to access this information. Next category of system calls is communication. Communication means I want to share some information with the device which is located in different position. So we use the communication system calls for that purpose. It has two models. Number one in message passing models, second is shared memory models. So message passing model, in here the information is exchanged through an inter-process communication, through an IPC facility provided by the operating system. Suppose I want to share information with this computer, so I send the request to that system. For this, the IPC facility is used. If I want to, first of all, I will send the request to that system. If he accept, then I will share my data. This all is happen through IPC, inter process communication method. Here the each computer in a network has a name by which it is known. Every system is designated by their names in networking system basically. Similarly, each process has a name, process name, which is translated to an equivalent identifier by which the operating system can refer to it. The get host ID and get process system calls to do this translation. These identifier are then passed to the general purpose for the open and close call provided by the file system or to specific open connection system calls. Here the recipient process must give its permission for the communication to take place with an accept connection calls. The source of the communication known as client and receiver, known as server exchange message by read message and write message system calls. And the close connection call terminate the connections. So here these process is completed. So this process, next is shared memory model. Shared memory means sharing of memory. Here the process use map memory system calls to access region of memory owned by other process. They exchange the information by reading and writing data in the shared areas. The process ensure that they are not writing to same location or simultaneously. So this is completed by this method. So these are the basic five category of system calls which help as a to interface between the process and the operating systems. And no need to confuse between these, but the same definition is for the operating system, but operating system act as an interface between the user and the hardware. But in between the users and the operating system, the system calls, in the process and between the operating system, the system calls act as an interface. So this was the concept of system calls. Next topic we will discuss today, generation of operating system. Generation. The first true digital computer was designed by English mathematician Charles Babbage in 1792 to 1871. The operating system has evolved over the year, so their evolution through the year can be mapped using generations of operating systems. There are four generations of operating system. Number one is first generation, was started from 1945 to 1955. The vacuum tubes and plug board was invented at this time. So the digital computer were not constructed until the Second World War. Calculating engines and mechanical relay were built at that time. However, the mechanical relays were very slow and were later replaced with vacuum tubes. These machines were enormous but were still very slow. This was the big problem that time. These early computers were designed, built and maintained by a single group of people. Here the programming language were unknown and there were no operating system. So all the programming was done in machine language and all the problems were simple numerical calculations. There was no operating system at that time. By the 1950s, punch card were introduced and this improved the computer systems, and instead of using plug board, program were written on card and read into the system. The programming was done here in card and read into the systems. This was the early stage of operating systems. In second generation, the transistor and base system was developed. Here the introduction of transistor in the mid of 1950s changed the picture radically. These machines, now called mainframes, were locked away in specially air-conditioned computer room with staff of professionals, operators to run them. To run a job, a set of programs basically, a program would first write the program on paper. The language was used that time, Fortran or assembler, then punch it on the card. Here the programmer writes up their program on paper and punches that paper into the card. When the computer finished whatever job it was currently running, an operator would go over to the printer and tear off the output and carry it over to the output room so that the programmer could collect it later. This was a very slow process during this period of writing the program or taking the printout. In third generation, the period of third generation was from 1965 to 1980. Here the IC and multiprogramming was developed. Integrated chip, IC circuit and multiprogramming task was come during this generation. Here the system of 1960 were also batch processing system, but they were able to take better advantage of computer's resources by running several jobs at once. What happened in multi-programming, more than program available in the RAM and the job was arranged in queue. The operating system designer developed the concept of multi-programming, in which the several jobs are in main memory at once. A processor is switched from one job to another job as needed to keep the several jobs advancing while keeping the peripheral devices in use. Basically, the basic motive of multi-programming is to the maximum CPU utilization. For example, on a system with no multi-programming, when the current job paused to wait for the other input operation to complete, the CPU simply sit idle until the input output finished. The solution for this problem that was evolved was to partition the memory into the several pieces with a different job in each partition. While one job was waiting for input output to complete, another job could be used by the CPU. Basically, another major feature of third generation operating system was the technique is called the spooling. Spooling means simultaneous peripheral operations online. It fulfilled the criteria, I suppose the criteria fulfilled the multi-programming task. The big advantage of this generation, the arrival of multi-programming. And fourth generation or current generation, here the personal computer works. The generation was started in 1980 to the present stage, presently. With it, here the VLSI was developed. VLSI means very large scale integration circuit. VLSI circuit or chips, operating system enter in the system, in the personal computer, and the workstation is Microprocessor technology evolved to the point that it became possible to build the desktop computer as powerful as the mainframe of the 1970s. Two operating systems had dominated the personal computer scene. MS-DOS, written by the Microsoft. DOS was the operating system developed by the Microsoft Corporation for the IBM PC and other machines using the Intel 8088 CPU and its successors, and Unix, which is dominant on the large personal computer using the Motorola 6899 CPU family. This is the advanced generation of current generation of the operating system is fourth generation. So students, thanks for today's lecture. So best of luck.